यस सर, 1487 पेज नंबर
4B
13 पार्ट टू।
पेज नंबर 87।
यस सर।
पेज 87। यस,
13 13
नंबर
पार्ट टू। 13 पार्ट टू
13। ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर
पार्ट,
13।
यस सर, पार्ट टू।
एरिया ऑफ लाइट ऑफ येलो कलर इज इंसिडेंट ऑन एन इक्विलेटरल ग्लास प्रिज्म एट एन एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस इक्वल टू 48 डिग्री एंड सफर्स मिनिमम डिविएशन बाय द एंगल ऑफ 36 डिग्री। ओके, व्हाट विल बी द एंगल ऑफ इमर्जेंस? सो फर्स्ट विल सी दिस वन, आफ्टर दैट This is equilateral prism, 60 degree, angle of incidence is 48 degree, it suffers minimum deviation, and minimum deviation you are given 36 degree. So deviation is minimum when angle of incidence is 48 degree. What will be this R? Now you are asked angle of emergence. So what will be E? That will be I, which is 48 degree. If you are asked R1, R2, you can find that 30 degree. Okay. Now what is asked? So angle of emergence we got. What will be the angle of emergence? If the angle of incidence is changed to 30 degree and B is 60 degree, state in each case which of the, or whether the angle of equal to less than or more than 36 degree. Okay. So you are given, when angle of incidence is 48 degree, deviation is minimum. So we have seen the graph. What was that? Graph is coming like this. So at this particular angle, minimum deviation. Suppose this is your 48 degree. Now if you are coming 30 degree, what is the deviation? More than this. This is your 36 degree. So it will be more than this. If you are 60 degree, then also it is more than this. So deviation is minimum when angle of incidence is 48 degree. At any other deviation, any other angle of incidence, deviation will be more than this. So deviation will always be more than 36 if angle of incidence is any, have any value then 48 degree. Any other value, if it is 48 then 36, or any other value it will be more than 36.
Sir, nothing will be less than 48. Nothing less than 36.
What will be, what is less than minimum?
Nothing.
Nothing. Minimum means the least one. So less than least, not possible. So whether angle of incidence is less than this particular value or more than this particular value, it will be, deviation will be more. Now suppose you are asked what is the refractive index. What will be? Sin 48 by sin 30 you have to find. Okay. Next one. Next one. No. Shall we start the next topic?
Yes, sir.
So come, yes. Council has given the revised syllabus. Have you seen that? Little revision is there. That is also in the last chapter, I think. You will have to go topic by topic, then only you will understand what is changed. So little topics are removed in between, and from the last chapter, half of the things are removed. Okay. So whatever we have done till now, all things are in syllabus. Now we are going to start this third part, that is simple applications of refraction of light. So first we will write the relation for between real depth, and apparent shift. So first application will be real depth, apparent depth. And apparent shift. So you have two different situations are there. If the ray is going from denser to rarer, or if the ray is going from rarer to denser. So two different situations are there. You might have seen the video in that. Three situations are given, but in our syllabus only two are there. That is when the object is placed in denser medium and is viewed from rarer medium. And the second is when the object is placed in rarer medium and viewed from denser medium. So those first two cases we have to discuss. Out of that, derivation only of first case. That is when the object is placed in denser medium. And is viewed from rarer. We may consider a glass block, we may consider a beaker in which water is filled. So suppose this is a beaker, water is filled up to this level. So when object is placed somewhere here, suppose a coin is placed here at the bottom. In place of bottom, it may be somewhere else also. Any floating object we can consider here also. So for this object, this will be the real depth from here to here. As the object is placed here, so real depth is from here to here. If object is here, the real depth is this much only. So when we see this object from air, that is above this water level, where will it appear? So to know that, we will have to consider two rays. So one ray we are considering which is going normally. So it will pass and deviate. So this is point A. The angle of incidence here is 0 degree. So it will go undeviated. Now any other ray? How many normal we can draw from this point on this line on this surface? How many normal? From this point on this surface, how many normal can be drawn?
One.
Only one. So as only many one ray will be incident normally. But one ray is not sufficient for formation of image. So we have to consider other ray also. So suppose second ray we are considering this one, okay. So we have considered this ray as it is going from denser to rarer, so it will bend away from normal. So suppose the refractive index of this is mu and this layer which is one only. Or this is suppose mu d, denser medium. This is air. Mu d or mu whatever symbol, mu will be used. So refractive index of this denser medium with respect to air is mu we are taking. So for this ray, this is the angle of incidence. I, this is angle of refraction, so this R will be more than I. It is not the same line. This line is bending away from the normal. Now these two rays are diverging this side. So here real image will not be formed this side. So when these two rays are produced back, they are intersecting at each other at this point. So here will be the image. So a virtual image will be formed at this point I, which is above its real position. When the object is placed in denser medium and viewed from rarer medium, its virtual position or position of the apparent position of the image will be above the object. Is it clear? Yes? No response.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Suppose this point we are taking B. Detailed derivation, yeah, I have given a new video. Everything is written clearly. Just to understand, we'll see here. So this is I. This angle will be I. Alternate angle. Perpendicular, this is mid-joining. So this I and this I, alternate angle. If this angle is R, This angle is also R. This is corresponding angle. Got? Again, this line joining, this is when we produce it. So this is also a straight line. So this angle and this angle are R. Now what will be sine I? Sine I is AB by OB. In this angle AOB, this sine I is this by this. Okay, right rectangle. Rectangle AOB. Rectangle AIB. Sin R is AB by IB or BI, whatever you may say. In this angle, sin R is, this is perpendicular, this is hypotenuse. AB by IB. Now, if you find sin I by sin R, that is refractive index of this medium with respect to this medium. So refractive index of air with respect to denser medium. So ray is going from this medium to this medium. So this is second medium. This is first medium. So this is our first medium. This is second medium. And according to Snell's law, sin I by sin R is refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. So second with respect to first. So if we, or it can be 1 by refractive index of denser with respect to air. In principle of reversibility we have seen. This will be inverse of this. Now, if you substitute this value, what will be? This AB by OB by AB by IB is 1 by mu. Now, this is mu. So IB over OB, this will go up, this will come down, is 1 by mu. Or we can say this OB by IB is mu. Yes, still here, any confusion? Yes.
No, sir.
No confusion. Now, if we view the object normally, that is, we are placing our eye here. Then what will be? The rays which are far will not enter into our eye. So, rays which are very close to point A will enter into our eye. That is, this OB will be also very close to OA. So formula will be only for this one. Numericals will be only for this one. This derivation will not be asked to you. Only you have to understand what will be. only formula we have to learn, and the numericals is in syllabus, so we have to do the numericals based on this apparent shift and apparent depth. So if object is viewed normally, B will be very close to E. That is, this part will come somewhere here. Naturally, what will be? This OA and OB will be same. Therefore, this OB will be approximately OA, and IB will be approximately IE. So, from this equation, what will we get? In place of OB, we will write OA. In place of IB, we will write IA is mu. So this OA we call real depth. IA we call apparent depth. This is refractive index of denser with respect to rarer or mu. So this is the formula. Now suppose this real depth is given T, or thickness of the slab sometimes given T. D will not be D, we have already used denser, so otherwise you will be confused. So suppose this is the thickness T. Then what will be the apparent depth? So real depth, that is T over apparent depth. Or we can say, okay, no problem. So apparent depth will be real depth over refractive index. Frequently we use this formula also to find apparent depth. Real depth by refractive index. Refractive index of denser with respect to air. Now sometimes apparent shift will be given and you will be asked to find maybe real depth, maybe refractive index, whatever it is. So what is apparent shift? So this apparent shift, this is OI. The object is really present at point O and appearing at point I. So we feel that the object has been shifted from here to here, but there is no actual shift. It is simply appearing. The object is not here, it is somewhere here. When you place a coin in the beaker filled with water or in a glass filled with water, you will feel that the coin has come up, or the bottom of the glass has come up, it is raised. It will not appear the same depth. So that's why we say it is apparent depth, it is appearing at this place. So this will be the apparent shift. So apparent shift is OI. Now what we can write? So this is OA minus IA. So in case of apparent shift, sometimes we give the symbol delta like this. This will be that is T minus T over mu. That is the difference of real depth and apparent depth. So it can be, we will take T common. 1 minus 1 by mu. You can use this formula. You can use directly this formula, or if apparent shift is given. Or here is mu minus 1, this mu will come this side. Okay, so whatever it is. So this way, this is the relation between real depth, and apparent shift. Now, this apparent shift or apparent depth, both are depending on what? Thickness and refractive index. This also, thickness and refractive index. So, both are depending on same factor. Now, refractive index depend on two things. Nature of the medium and color or wavelength of incident light. So there are three factors on which this apparent shift or apparent depth depend. Now you see, if apparent shift increases, naturally apparent depth will decrease. No, if object is not appearing here, it is appearing somewhere here. So apparent shift increases, that means apparent depth decreases. So both will not increase together. But when we increase the depth, real depth, both will increase. Well, it is directly proportional. Delta is directly proportional to T, and delta is, this apparent depth is also directly proportional to T. So if you increase the real depth, both will increase. No? Suppose there is only this much is there, then what will be? Shift will be very small, negligible. Apparent depth is also small. If liquid is filled up to here, both will increase. Apparent shift is also here. Apparent depth is also here. So both are increasing. So we have to see the factors. So factors on which apparent shift and apparent depth depend. So one is the thickness of slab or real depth. Real depth, always we find the depth from the free surface, from where you are viewing. As we are viewing from above, so from this surface, how much below the object is placed. So from where you are viewing, from that surface, what is the distance of the object? So in this case, what will be the apparent shift and apparent depth? Both are directly proportional. Second is refractive index. Now see, apparent depth was E by mu. Forget about P. P suppose 1. Okay. So what will be here? 1 minus 1 by mu. Mu is suppose 1.5. Okay. 1 by this much. And here is 1 by 1.5. Which is more? Which is more? Or indirectly you can see if we increase this, what will be the effect? Okay. Suppose it is 1.2, then what will be? If it is 1.2, then what will be? If this is increasing, naturally this will decrease. If this is decreasing, this one will increase. When this will decrease? When this refractive index is more. So when the refractive index of the denser medium is more, apparent depth will decrease and apparent shift will increase.